Do you have a problem with Christians or with Christ? Think about it for a moment. I can't help but to recall a conversation I had with my older brother before he died. He had a strong aversion to Christianity, and he told me that he wanted nothing to do with the church. I asked him why he hated Christianity so much, and he told me because they're all a bunch of hypocrites. They talk a big game about doing the right thing, following Jesus, and loving each other, but when it comes to actually doing anything, they never seem to come through. The church is full of hypocrites who claim to follow God, but they're no better than anyone else. It was interesting when he said all that to me, because I couldn't help but wholeheartedly agree with him. For a long time, I had grown to dislike the church too. Not the teachings or going to church itself, but the people in the church. I felt that everyone was nitpicking the parts of the Bible they liked, and leaving out all the hard parts of it that they didn't. They love all the parts about grace and forgiveness, but when it comes to verses like, "If you love me, you will keep my commands," they'll turn a blind eye. They take God's forgiveness and grace for granted. They pervert the grace of God into a license for immorality. Like my brother said, they talk a big game, but when it comes to actually doing anything, they're dead. It really is a shame because this feeling is pretty common among people that I speak to. They had one bad experience with the church, and now they throw away the entire religion because of it. I don't even think I blame them. When I encounter these people, I now ask them one simple question. Do you have a problem with Christians or with Christ? Because I'll be honest, I still have major problems with Christians. I saw the hypocrisy with my own eyes growing up. A good little Christian boy in church who sings in the choir and says all the right answers in youth group would be texting his friends about buying drugs in the pews. And the girl that acts innocent in church but parties every weekend and sleeps with every other guy she bumps into, this type of thing plagues the church. Is it any surprise that people look at Christians and think that we are nothing special? What's different about us? We don't look like the church that's described in Acts. We have no love or forgiveness, we don't stand up for anything, we're divided on every little issue possible, and we cherry-pick sins we want to get angry about. I always found it pretty hilarious that people in church would single out gay relationships while they themselves were on their third marriage, and their kids were probably sleeping around too. That's hypocrisy. That's the type of stuff that turns people off. Sexual immorality is sexual immorality, whether it's straight or gay. Don't be a hypocrite about it. That's not even to mention the divorce rates in the church are on par with the secular world. That needs to stop. Haven't you heard that God hates divorce? The church is just like the world and they're not even trying to hide it anymore. The church copies the secular music, the secular trends, everything. It's almost like the church is trying to be friends with the world at this point. It's funny because I think I remember reading something in the Bible about that. And where's the love in the church? If these churchgoers truly believe that everyone goes to hell apart from having a relationship with Jesus, then why aren't they attempting to save people? They have no convictions about it. They're perfectly fine with letting people go to hell because they're worried about getting mocked. It's funny, I think I remember reading some verses about that too. But you, I ask you again, do you have a problem with Christ or with Christians? I let my feelings about Christians stop my relationship with Christ. Are you doing what I did? I'll tell you what, I was wrong in doing that. If I could encourage you to do anything, this is it. Don't let the hypocrisy in the church dissuade you from following Christ. Christ said it himself, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my Father who is in heaven." Chances are, if Jesus were here right now, he'd be condemning all these fake Christians too. It was this that helped bring me back to the church. It was looking at the examples in the Bible and seeking them rather than the abomination of a church that America has now. Most Christians go to church and pretend that everything is perfect and they wear these big fake smiles. But most of them are in desperate pain. They just don't show it. They're afraid to show it. They're afraid of being judged. But when did we forget that the church is not a place to be perfect? The church should be full of broken people that know they need Christ. The church is a hospital for sinners. A place where we can confess our sins without judgment and be forgiven of all iniquities. The church is the body of Christ. No one should be cast away if they are seeking help. So here is what I'm urging you to do. If you've had a bad experience in the church, put that behind you for a moment and read the Bible. Read the Gospel of John and Acts. See who Jesus was and how the church after him followed suit. Use that as a lens for finding a good church to go to. Find a solid group of believers and fellowship with them. Seek out the people that actually have some semblance of living like Christ rather than what the world is doing. Those who are being transformed by the renewing of their minds. We just have to let God handle the church as a whole. He will judge that part. You just follow Jesus with all your heart and do not let these other people get in the way. He is the good shepherd that we follow. Obey him, not man. It is not our job to weed out the wheat from the tares or separate the sheep from the goats. God will handle that on the day of judgment. Focus on making sure you are one of his sheep. Give your life to him and pray for the forgiveness of your sins. He has promised that anyone who comes to him will not be cast out. Be in his word and be transformed by his spirit. He is the good shepherd who leads his flock.